this year.
Good morning, everybody. How are you guys doing today?
Good morning.
Welcome to chapel today. It's Wednesday, April 14th. Just think, we have only like 32 days left of school. That's pretty cool. Then you guys can join us. For today, I'm going to have you guys stand, start with for our new vocation. And we begin. We begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are thankful to God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for their blessings. With our mouths, God has given us hands to show care for others, to do our and His work, as well as worship Him. With our hands, God has given us people to serve and spread His gospel. With our feet, God has given us clothing, shoes, house and home, friends, family, teachers, health, salvation, forgiveness, and life eternal. Faith Lutheran, make a joyful noise to the Lord. O Lord, this day and all days, open our lips that we may declare your praise.
Amen.
Yes,
bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on saying. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. When my strength is failing, The end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
clue one, was it after clue two? Did you wait till clue five? But before we get to that, who thinks they know who this mystery servant is? I'm going to go right there. Chuck Carroll? You forgot his name, but you know him? All right, I bet you do know him. Eric, what do you think? Abraham! Go ahead and take a look.
I am the son of Abraham.
All right, let's be honest now. How many of you knew it after just one clue? Raise your hand if you didn't have one. Few of you, some of the older kids. How many took two clues? That's not too bad. Three? Some of you? How many took till four? Anybody had to wait till five? All right, some of the younger guys. And that's okay. So good job with that. We figured out who this mystery person is. Now, I have a Bible reading that I need to read to you. And that comes from Genesis chapter 12, verses 1 through 9. The Lord had said to Abram, "Go from your country, your people, and your father's household to the land that I show you. I will make you to a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. And all the people on earth will be blessed through you." So Abram went, as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he set out from Haran. He took his wife Sarah, his nephew Lot, all the possessions that they had accumulated, and all the people that they acquired in Haran. And they set out for the land of Canaan, and they arrived there. Abram traveled through the land as far as the site of the great trade war at Shechem. At that time, the Canaanites were in the land. The Lord appeared to Abram and said, "To your offspring I will give this land." So Abram built an altar there to the Lord who had appeared to him. From there he went toward the hills east of Bethel and pitched his tent, with Bethel on the west and Ai on the east. There he built an altar to the Lord and called on the name of the Lord. Then Abram set out and continued toward the Negev. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Now, we're going to be talking a little bit about Abraham. And he was a servant. But for many earthly ideas and perspectives, Abraham wasn't a servant. Abraham, he would have been that person who had been served by other people. If we were to read in Genesis, we would learn that Abraham was very wealthy. He had livestock. He owned land. He was wealthy. He wasn't a servant. People served him, but yet God chose him. We also know that Abraham was a rescuer, and he rescued his nephew Lot from the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. So Abraham seems like he's a pretty good choice, but servants? I don't know. Pretty wealthy to be a servant. People that are wealthy have servants. Now, as I read the Old Testament, sometimes I forget the people of the Old Testament, the people of the New Testament, they're people just like you and I. Sometimes we think the people in the Bible are so much better than we are. But yet, we see that Abraham was a liar. He lied and told people that his wife was really his sister just to protect himself. That's not very nice to be a liar. We also see that Abraham was doubtful. He oftentimes would doubt that God would keep the promise to give him an heir. And Abraham devised his own plan instead of leaning on God. And like every descendant of Adam and Eve, just like you and me, Abraham was a sinner. So it's hard sometimes to remember that these people that we read about in the Bible are people just like you and I. If we go ahead and read in Psalm 105, verse 42, we see that Abraham was called his servant. Abraham was God's servant. Abraham was chosen by God. And Abraham and his family were chosen by God to be the family through which the Savior would come. If we look at the family history of Jesus and Matthew, we see Jesus' heritage that's traced all the way back to Abraham. Abraham was God's trusting servant. When God told Abraham, hey, I want you to pack up and leave everything behind and go to a new land, Abraham trusted God. He got up and he left. When God told Abraham that he and Sarah were going to have a son at their old age, now remember, how old was Abraham in this Bible reading? Zeke, you remember? 75. That's way older than me. I don't want to have kids anymore. Are you kidding me? Not a chance. Abraham, 75. But yet, Abraham trusted God. And God fulfilled that promise. When God told Abraham to sacrifice his son, Isaac, Abraham trusted him. And he knew that God would provide. And God did that. He provided a sacrifice for Abraham so that he didn't have to sacrifice his son Isaac. Abraham trusted God's plan to send a Savior. Now, like Abraham, we here at Faith are also God's chosen servants. God chose us to be his children through our baptism. God brought us into his family. And God chooses to be with us and to bless us. The Savior who came from Abraham's family is our Savior, Jesus. And Jesus came to be the perfect servant for us, fulfilling God's plan. We too are trusting servants. Like Abraham, we receive God's promises. God may not ask us to pack up everything and move to a new land, or ask us to sacrifice like he did to Abraham. But God does promise to bless us and to be with us on all of our journeys. He promises to go with us. Let's go ahead and fold our hands. Jesus, thank you for your servant Abraham. Like Abraham, may we faithfully believe your promises to us. And may we faithfully follow you. Amen. Let's go ahead and stand, and I'm going to have you join me in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
Blessed
be
the Holy Spirit,
Christian flag back here on the right and the United States flag on the left. Let's go ahead and pledge. We will start pledge to the Christian flag first.
To the cross.
And for the addiction, you just face each other, this side, face that side. This way, if you need to, you got it on the screen, if you don't know the words. God the Father sent his Son down into the world to suffer and die on the cross for you and for me. You guys may go ahead and be seated, and I will hand it over to Mr. Leach.